बी रेडी, फाइव सेकेंड्स स्टार्ट। सर, प्लानिंग इज द वाइटल इंस्ट्रूमेंट वी हैव अडॉप्टेड टू रियलाइज द सोशल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स एनश्राइंड इन आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। थ्रू द 5-year प्लान्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी अचीव्ड ए सिग्निफिकेंट इंक्रीज इन द नेशनल इनकम इन द पास्ट 18 years एंड लेड द फाउंडेशंस ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजिकल एडवांस। द प्लान इज फास्ट मॉडर्नाइजिंग आवर एग्रीकल्चर एंड strengthening and diversifying our industry. Above all, it has reinforced national unity and purpose. The attack on our territory in 1962 and again in 1965 forced us to modify the pattern of national expenditure. Before we could reconcile the competing claims of development and defense, drought struck us. Foreign credits became uncertain. Recession followed. All these seriously restricted our freedom of choice. We had to divert our energies to fight drought and near famine and their aftermath. For some time, long-term planning had to be virtually suspended. But we succeeded in turning adversity to good use. We concentrated on import substitution, which further enlarged our industrial base. This, along with the need for more foreign exchange, put us on the path of a more fruitful export drive. We maintained our investment in development work, especially in intensive agricultural programs. A new period has now opened. There is a welcome upsurge in the economy and the increases in agricultural production have brought us nearer to self-sufficiency in food grains. But inevitably, there are other problems and a fresh challenge to face. Rural disparities have increased partly owing to the very efforts we have made to move rapidly towards self-sufficiency in food and partly owing to a certain slowness in the matter of implementing the land reforms. Although the industrial recession has been curbed, new industries are not coming fast enough and unemployment, especially of technically trained persons, continues to be acute. We have a larger and understandably enough and more distinct population. Planning is the method to which we are committed for meeting such challenges. We have carried out 3 5-year plans. Each 5-year plan has addressed itself specially to problems which have emerged either because of new political and economic developments in the country and in the world or as a consequence of progress we have already achieved. The priorities and the emphasis have necessarily changed and have had to be adjusted from plan to plan, but we have always kept in view our long-term objectives and their achievement. The 7th plan represents a conscious, internally consistent and carefully thought out program for the most efficient exploitation of our resources possible in existing conditions. The basic aim is to raise the standard of living of the people, especially of the less privileged sections of society. Our planning should result not only in an integrated process of increased production, but rational distribution of the added wealth. The overriding inspiration must be a burning sense of social justice. While increased production is of the utmost importance, it is equally important to remove or reduce and prevent the concentration of wealth and economic power. The benefits of development should accrue in increasing measure to the common man and the weaker sections of society so that the forces of production can be fully unleashed. A sense of involvement or participation by the people as a whole is vital for the success of any plan of rapid economic growth. This can only be evoked by securing social justice, by reducing disparities of income and wealth, by redressing regional imbalances. Our orientation of our socio-economic institutions in this spirit is accordingly the first necessity. 1 year of this plan has already gone by. Between the draft plan and the present document, certain important changes have been made. The projected investment in the public sector has been stepped up so as to enable us to undertake a larger and bolder agenda of work. New schemes have been added to help the small farmer throughout the country, especially in the unirrigated areas. The emphasis is squarely on areas that have hitherto suffered from neglect of transport and housing problems in urban regions will receive more attention. A small but significant beginning is also being made with special programs for children. The seventh plan thus provided a necessary corrective to the earlier trend, which helped particularly the stronger sections in agriculture as well as in industry to enable them rapidly to enlarge and diversify the production base. In the long run, the full potential of growth cannot be realized unless the energies of all our people are put to profitable use. The emphasis on spreading the impetus and benefits of economic growth to the weaker sections is thus necessary in the interest of equality as well as growth. The plan will now assist the less prosperous sections of our farming population to improve their position and make a yet bigger contribution to the national economy. Greater industrial activity and the modernization of agriculture by adopting intensive methods of cultivation and irrigation would mean that a larger proportion of young men seeking jobs could find employment nearer home.